Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of LEGO Weaponry, and today we have another suggested weapon from you guys, and this one has been a suggestion by Extreme Guns LEGO Creations. So yes, this has been a suggestion for quite some time now. You know, this has been a suggestion in the video that I've made, which is called the LEGO SIG 552, I believe. So yeah, feel free to check that out if you've missed that out or whatever. So either way, let's have a look at this weapon. Now this is also one of my favorite weapons of all time, just because it's got a cool design to it. It looks so much like a space weapon and all that. So anyway, here it is. Oh yes, now this is bound to be the F2000, which is made in a Belgian firearms company called FN Herstal, I believe. So yes, anyway, let's have a look at the comparisons between this LEGO version and the actual version, as well as with the top accessory on top. So anyway, let's have a look. Interesting stuff. Right, let's show you the areas and features of this particular weapon. First thing first, well, here's the good old stock here. It's kind of heavy for what it is, but doesn't really bother me that much. The magazine, that was kind of hard to do because I didn't know if the whole thing was curvy or not, but this is my design. I don't know if it's correct, but I try my best. So yes, I don't know what cartridge it fires, but hopefully the facts will mention it anyway. So yep, that goes in here like so. Pistol grip, good old angles. What else? Oh yes, the trigger. Well, it's hidden away, so there you go. I've forgotten one section or feature at the bottom here, and that's the select fire or the safety here. I'm not so sure, but I've forgotten that piece because, well, I didn't know how to do that just because I had such little space to do that with, so I'll have to leave that out, unfortunately. So sorry if that feature ain't in this one. So did some detailings of the front grip here with the gaps and all that, so just to be sure that it is that weapon. So yes, and the one strange thing I found on this weapon is that the breech is at the front instead of where the magazine is positioned, which is kind of odd because you expect a bullpup design to have the breech at the back, but no, it's at the front. I mean, I'm confused. I mean, feel free to tell me on how this has worked or, you know, used and all that in the comments below. You know, feel free, because I have no idea on how this is actually fired. So I don't know if, well, obviously the charging handle or the bolt catches the cartridge and pushes it into position, but I mean, this is all confusing in some ways, but there you go, it's a gun. So anyway, let's move on. Barrel, muzzle, oh yes, the that does move, so don't you worry, like so. Charging handle, well, this particular one, I've done it's two studs wide. It's just so that I can get a good old grip on it, because if it were to be a one stud wided section, I wouldn't be able to get good hold of it, so that's why I did it thick enough to actually grab hold onto it. So yes, the sightings and the Picatinny rail, or Picatinny rail, or something, whatever you call it. So I'll try my best with the sights. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I can't really get that higher, so sorry if it's not perfect, but hey ho, at least I'll do the first person view later on or whatever. So anyway, I will put the extra accessory on right now, so I'll be right back. So here it is, ladies and gentlemen, the extra top piece, which makes it look more recognisable, I may say, because it looks pretty badass, I've got to tell you. It's so cool, such a cool design, very small, very compact, and pretty darn easy to do. So anyway, I don't know if you could see down the optics on this one, but yeah, it's more like a T-shape. It's like your point of view is at the middle of that T-shape rectangle, so yeah, quadri physics. So anyway, this is all I have time for you guys, unfortunately, today, but join me tomorrow for a made-up weapon which I've made in my own head. And well, really, this is another made-up pistol that I've made up, and have I mentioned that it's made up? I'm pretty sure. So anyway, join me tomorrow for that weapon. But if you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to leave a like or a comment down below what you think of this episode. It should help me a lot. But if you really liked it, want to subscribe to my channel and keep the channel growing, it should help me a lot as well. Always keep up to date with videos that I do as well. And if you're new around the channel, welcome. Probably to have a look around content that I have done in the past, but you want to keep up to date with the rest of the community, that's how that's probably the way it is up to you. So yes, join me next time for more weapons that I do and more gaming videos that I do, and as always, enjoy the rest of your days. Salutes!